إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعين به ونستهديه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، المنزه عن الشبيه والمثيل والكفء والنظير، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله وخيرته من خلقه وحبيبه، أرسله الله تعالى رحمةً للعالمين وحجةً على الخلق أجمعين، فهدى الله عز وجل به من الضلالة، وبصر به من الجهالة، وكثر به بعد القلة، وأغنى به بعد العيلة. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك على محمدٍ وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اقتفى أثرهم وسار على دربهم إلى يوم الدين. عباد الله، إن قضية الرزق من أعظم القضايا التي انشغلت بها قلوب العباد، انشغلت بها قلوبهم وسيطرت على عقولهم حتى تركوا ما كلفوا به وقد كفوه. قال الله عز وجل في كتابه: وما من دابة في الأرض إلا على الله رزقها. وقال تعالى: وكأي من دابة لا تحمل رزقها الله يرزقها وإياكم وهو السميع العليم. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, one of the distinct features of life that all of us negotiate on a day-to-day basis is the question of rizq, is the question of sustenance. All of us, every single day, are navigating the issue of money, family, belongings, food, drink, and so on and so forth. And no doubt that this feature of dunya is extremely consuming. It is extremely, at times, overwhelming. Some people, sometimes they cannot sleep at night peacefully because they think about rizq. Some people neglected the ibadah because they go after the rizq day and night. Some people do not spend time with their family and children simply because they're so busy seeking the rizq. And seeking your rizq is highly, highly encouraged and recommended in the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, often people forget that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ar-razzaq. You know that. And this is part of tawheed. And this is part of the aqeedah of tawheed al-rububiyyah, the unity of lordship, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the sustainer, the one who sustains and provides for everything. We know it and we believe in it, but at the same time, it has become like a theory. And many people forget that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ar-razzaq. Many people forget that one of the most manifest qualities, descriptions, and attributes of Allah azza wa jal is ar-razzaq. He's the one who gives, not once or twice, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the giver, always, with no limit. He subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمَا مِن دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا. There is no living, moving animal, creature on the face of this earth except that its rizq is upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every dabba, not only the human beings, but the jinns, animals, birds, insects. Every single dabba, it's a rizq upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran, وَكَأَيِّمْ مِنْ دَابَّةٍ لَا تَحْمِلُ رِزْقَهَا اللَّهُ يَرْزُقُهَا وَإِيَّاكُمْ. How many a living, moving creature that does not carry its own rizq, does not carry its own sustenance. Many moving animals and human beings are not capable of seeking their rizq. And the ayah says, Allah Azza wa Jal says, Allahu yarzuquha, Allah provides for it and for you. Allah provides for it and for you. And on the tafsir of this ayah, and this ayah is in Surah Al-Ankabut, ayah number 60, Ibn Kathir rahimahullah ta'ala gave us a very beautiful example to show how great is the rizq of Allah and how it suffices all forms of creation. He gave the example of a crow, al-ghurab. And then when the crow lays an egg and then it hatches into a chick, the parents fly away. Ibn Kathir gave us this example in his tafsir. About that, there are many a living, moving creature that does not carry its own rizq, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides for it and for you. So he said the crow, when it lays an egg and it hatches into a chick, the parents of the chick fly away. They fly away in the first 3 days. Why? Because the crow is featherless. It does not have any feathers, so they do not like even to see their babies like this. In the first 3 days, they fly away. They do not give them any food, drink, or anything whatsoever. Then Ibn Kathir rahimahullah ta'ala said, the chick opens its beak. It opens its mouth looking for something. Looking for some food, for sustenance, for rizq. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed another bird, not its parents, not a crow, that would come and gives it food and drink in the next 3 days. And then after that, when the feathers start to appear, the parents of the crow would come back and then look after their children. Subhanallah. Allah says, وَكَأَيِّمْ مِنْ دَابَّةٍ لَا تَحْمِلُ رِزْقَهَا. How many a living creature that does not carry its own rizq, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides for it and for you, and وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, لَوْ أَنَّ ابْنَ آدَمْ يهرب من رزقه كما يهرب من الموت لأدركه رزقه كما يدركه الموت. If the son of Adam were to flee from his rizq, and listen carefully to this, if the son of Adam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, if the son of Adam were to flee from his rizq, the same way that he flees from death, the same way that he flees from maut. You know what the Quran says? قُلْ إِنَّ الْمَوْتَ الَّذِي تَفِرُّونَ مِنْهُ فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ. The death from which you flee or you run away, it will surely find you. It will surely meet you. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, if the son of Adam were to flee from his rizq as he flees from death, his rizq would surely reach him as just his death will reach him. Even if you do not seek it, it will seek you. Even if you do not look after it, it will go after you. It is guaranteed. from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah azza wa jal says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ I have not created mankind and jinn except for one purpose. And that purpose is the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقِ مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقِ I do not need any rizq from them. وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَنْ يُطْعِمُونَ Nor do I want that they should feed me. Allah huwa الرزاق ذو القوة المتين. It is guaranteed. No matter how much you do and how many struggles you have, you will not get more than what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed for you. This issue of rizq has been mentioned in the Quran 123 times. 123 times Allah talks about rizq, and most of which essentially addresses how it comes from Allah, and it is He who determines what a person should obtain in this life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in most of these 123 ayahs, connected rizq, sustenance with the worship of Allah Azza wa Jal. Why, the respected brothers and sisters in Islam? Because seeking rizq has become one of the primary distraction from the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for this reason, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned ibadah, and then rizq comes after ibadah. فَبِتَغُوا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الرِّزْقِ وَاعْبُدُوهُ وَاشْكُرُوا لَهُ إِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ It is as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that do not let your rizq or seeking your rizq or going after it distract you from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or for the main purpose of this life. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَن تَمُوتَ نَفْسٌ حَتَّى تَسْتَكْمِلَ رِزْقَهَا وَأَجَلَهَا He said, إِنَّ رُوحَ الْقُدُسِ The Holy Spirit, Jibreel alayhi salam, inspired me that not a single soul and not a single person will die until his lifespan has reached its full cycle. And not a single person will die without or before getting his rizq in its full. And he said, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ Be mindful of Allah and وَأَجْمِلُوا فِي الطَّلَبِ and seek it through permissible means. Seek it through permissible means. It is guaranteed from the time you came into existence. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guaranteed your rizq. Not only for Muslims. Muslims and kafirs, weak and strong, men and women, young and old, birds and animals, insects, and your rizq is not based upon your lineage, is not based upon your family name, is not based upon your qualification, is not based upon the language you speak or the nationality you hold. Sometimes, subhanAllah, you might see a person highly, highly educated and his rizq is very little. On the other hand, you may see a person, his ummi, doesn't know how to read nor write. Maybe even does not speak a single word of English. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them many rizq. And you keep thinking, I have this much degrees and certificates and qualifications. And I have this much. And this man does not even speak proper English. And he see 5-6 stores and money on top of money. And this is the subhanallah, the decree and the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu yabusutu al-rizqa liman yasha'u wa yaqdir. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. Fastaghfiruhu innahu huwa al-ghafur al-rahim. Alhamdulillah. Wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. Wa ala alihi wa ashabihi wa man ihtada bi hudah. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يد الله ملأة Allah's hand is full لا تغيضها نفقة سحاء الليل والنهار He said Allah's hand is full and its fullness is not affected. Its fullness is not affected by his continuous spending. Day and night. And the Prophet said, أَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا أَنْفَقَ مُنْذُ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ فَإِنَّهُ لَمْ يَغِضْ مَا فِي يَدِهِ. The Prophet said, do you see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has spent since he created the heavens and the earth? Do you see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has spent since he created the heavens and the earth? All of it. Do not decrease what is in his hand. All of it. All of it. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has spent from the beginning of creation. Subhanallah, does not decrease what is in his hand. And Allah gives without limit. This is just an introduction to the topic of rizq. It's a very important topic. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يَأْتِي عَلَى الْمَرْءِ زَمَانٌ لَا يُبَالِي مَا أَخَذْ لَا يُبَالِي مَا أَخَذَ مِنْ أَمِنَ الْحَرَامِ أَمْ مِنْ حَلَالِ. He said, there will come a time, there will come a time when a man would not care anymore what he earns, whether it's from a halal source or a haram source. Meaning the Prophet said, a time will come when seeking rizq and seeking money will become one's main concern in this life, to the point that he does not care whether this money is halal money or haram money. People sometimes, they say, Shaykh, I make a lot, but I cannot save anything. I'm struggling. And some people, subhanAllah, they make little, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts a lot of barakah in it. And let's talk, inshaAllah ta'ala, maybe in a khutbah or two, about how you have barakah in your rizq, because rizq is not restricted to money. Rizq is not restricted to money. This is only one aspect of it. Rizq is much, much more than that. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, taking into consideration the severe cold weather outside, we'll end the khutbah today, inshaAllah ta'ala. Allahumma aghnina bihalalika an haramik, wa bifadlika amman siwak. Allahumma aghnina bihalalika an haramik, wa bifadlika amman siwak. وأقم الصلاة.